Jim, the floor looks much different than when we got here yesterday.
Yeah, it turned out pretty good, Keith.
Yesterday, Jim and I came in this room and we prepared it for the use with Element's water-based stain.
As you can see, we've taken the plastic and protected the wall here. We went a little higher than normal because we're going to be spraying an Element's water-based stain, and we just want to protect against any overspray.
Right, and after we got finished with that, what we did is we used a product by Butterfield Color called CHO Cleaner to clean the surface of any contaminants. It's a dry powder that you mix 1 pound of material with 1 gallon of water. We put it on the floor and we moved it around, and then we neutralized the surface afterward to make sure it was a neutral pH.
Yeah, another good thing that the CHO is good for, Keith, is that it opens the floor, opens the pores up. It allows the Element stain to penetrate and get a better hold and work a little bit better due to the porosity of the floor.
Is that needed?
Very important.
And I noticed you have some equipment sitting over here. What is this equipment for?
Yeah, for this project, we've picked the HVLP sprayer to use on this job.
Okay.
It's going to atomize the product, and it'll allow us to layer out the color on the slab.
Okay.
We could have chosen an airless sprayer that's pretty popular with the paint industry. That would be for a larger project. On this one, I think the HVLP will work fine.
By the airless sprayer, do you mean a pump-up sprayer?
No, not a pump-up sprayer at all, Keith.
Okay.
A pump-up sprayer is going to dispense too much product on the floor,
okay.
Puts it on way too thick, doesn't allow it to penetrate properly. So an HVLP or an airless sprayer is the tool of choice for this type of product.
All right, what we have over here is the stain itself, Jim?
Yeah, this is our Butterfield Color Elements. It's a water-based color. Pretty much at this point, we're ready to mix up the product, get it in the gun, and get moving.
Sounds great. Well, I'm gonna go grab my clothes, and I'll be back in a minute to give you a hand.
Make you my grinder. Countdown. Elements water-based stained area. You can see that there's a mottled look on the floor. We achieve this by applying two different colors of the water-based stain to get that mottled look. Remember, stains are not to hide defects. They can only enhance them. After we applied the stains and it was thoroughly dry, we applied two coats of ClearGuard H2O Wet Look Sealer. Once that was dried, we are now ready to apply our wax surface. The wax becomes the sacrificial wear coating of the floor itself. As with an automobile, you should have a good coat of wax on your floor. We will be putting several coats on the floor, and the only additional maintenance would be to damp mop or occasionally re-wax the floor. As with water-based sealers, this wax appears to be milky white in color, but does dry clear. It comes in both gloss and a matte finish, depending on the look that you are looking for. When applying the wax, even when it's dry, it can appear very slick, as a slippery surface. But the wax does have some slip resistance in it. Contact your wax manufacturer to see what this surface coefficient of friction is.
I woke up today, a song was swimming in my head, and I hummed it to myself as I got out of bed. And on the way to take a shower, it all just dawned on me that a song like this just might go down in history.